गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। हाय द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज कंप्लियंस। आर यू एबल टू हियर मी? मनीषा?
यस मैम। हेलो मैम। हेलो 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 मैम।
ओ मनीषा, वेट वेट।
ओके मैम।
हाँ आ रहे हैं। देखो देखो, ऐसा कर। All right. So compliance Compliance issues arises because of the conflicting regulations and laws of different countries or regions. 1 minute. Well, this compliance arises because of this conflicting regulations. As discussed earlier, there is no standard and uniform law related to this, legal and illegal activities with respect to this cloud. Every country has got its own rules and regulations, and sometimes these are conflicting with one another. When a service provider of cloud is in one country and the consumer is in another country, here there is a law and here also there is another law, and both are not similar. When both are different, to which law these two stakeholders involved should abide by, whether they should follow this country one law or a country true law. So essentially here, this compliance discuss about how this conflicting problem is resolved. And there are new regulations and standards around the world that makes it difficult for global enterprises to maintain performance objectives. Global enterprises, which are spread across the globe, you know, they may have branch here. So they are spread across the globe. And there are new regulations and standards across the world. And to which standard this enterprise abides, and how things will work out. And with the adoption of cloud computing, enterprises need to move their application and data from internal infrastructure to cloud providers' infrastructural facilities to span the businesses worldwide. And cloud services as well as infrastructure by its own nature spread over multiple countries and continents. I hope these points are making sense to you. And different regions might have different regulatory requirements. And therefore, there is overlapping regulatory requirements to be maintained by the service provider in a coherent manner. So cloud computing does not raise any new compliance issues, but it makes existing ones more complex. This is mainly for the reason that cloud data in cloud are stored in multiple locations. Hence, the data stored in cloud may get stored in multiple other countries that those follow different regulatory or legal systems. And this increases the complexity for a system to handle. And hence, to comply with all those overlapping or interconflicting regulations and laws, the service provider must attentively design and manage their services and systems. So the bottom line here is that service providers must attentively design and manage their services and systems that considers these overlapping or interconflicting regulations and laws. And why these compliance issues arises? Because of conflicting regulations. What are the concerns related to compliance? Primarily, we have regulatory concern, performance, security, and legal. Performance compliance or security related compliance are technical issues and are not difficult to achieve with proper expertise and effort. However, regulatory and legal compliance issues are the main concerns. All right, so the main concern regarding compliance in cloud computing is legal compliance, not the other technical compliance. And here, SLA must address all of the compliance related issues. SLA has got a extremely significant role in establishing various terms and conditions, which also includes this compliance related issues. And whenever there is some violation observed, it must be sorted immediately between two parties. And when regulatory performance and security issues can be resolved between cloud server provider and consumer, any solution regarding non-compliance of legal issues depend on jurisdiction of the concerned geographical region. If they are not able to resort to a solution and there is non-compliance of legal issues, then under the jurisdiction of concerned geographical region, it must be presented. And whose responsibility is it to maintain this compliance? It is not only the provider's responsibility. It must also involve consumers. Consumers do have a role to play to fulfill all the compliance requirements. And this and both parties have to cooperate with each other to resolve it. Security related compliance is one of the issues that must be monitored and addressed by the cloud service provider. And for legal compliance, both cloud service provider and consumer will have to be cautious and strategic and should choose to store some business organizations' data within their business jurisdiction to avoid compliance related problems. Our enterprise may select a CSP who provide options for storing data at data centers of consumer's choice. Here, compliance can be addressed either by having organizations storing their sensitive data within their premises, or they can go for a CSP that that facilitate storing of the data at a consumer's choice location. Well, apparently consumer do not have any choice over the location of the data that is being stored. For instance, we are using cloud, Google Drive, Dropbox, and others. They don't give us the choice to choose the location where our data will be residing. But then there are a few cloud service providers that provide this option. So organizations, in order to avoid compliance related issues, can look for any one of the solution here. Governance, risk, and compliance. So good governance is treated as a potentially measurable commodity. Risk management and compliance to the regulation are also important for organizations to gain confidence. When a client approaches a business, there is a business, a client approaches this business. Client majorly looks for the good governance. Whenever a student joins a university or a college, even a student look for how is everything maintained and managed, and how things are properly planned and implemented. Likewise, any business and client also has this good governance concern. And likewise, we have risk management and compliance. Risk management, how a business is dealing with its risks and how business is following the regulations. That also gives the confidence to the business and attracts more clients. GRC is an umbrella term. This is an umbrella term covering organization approaches towards the three areas of governance, risk management, and compliance. How is any organization managing and dealing with governance, risk management, and compliance. And these things must be properly planned. Governance, it means the approaches or strategies taken by the management of an organization which governs their policy or business. What are the approaches or strategies an organization is being implemented based on their policies? Every organization has their vision, their policy statement, and based on that they are implementing them through some approaches and strategies. Risk management. Risk cause adverse effect on the business. There can be a security risk, there can be natural calamity risk, there can be data being stolen risk. Well organized risk management strategy is necessary so that it deals with any situation that that brings a adverse impact on the organization. Compliance, this is related with any business, need to be abided by some standard. Which standard business is, like if you remember, the college has gone for NAC. There was a NAC committee visiting, and then they have verified and checked all the documents, the infrastructure, everything, and then they have given the rating to the college. There might be some standards, and there are some regulations a company must abide by any business. So compliance, with all the technical institutions are affiliated under AICT or under Sumania University, like that, they have to follow certain regulations. And then there's GRC is a term that reflects the way in which organization adopt an integrated approach towards governance, risk, and compliance. The steps to address GRC. What are the steps to address GRC? Here, risk assessment. In order to address any risk, first, a business should identify the risk. Whether risk has occurred or is there any chance of a risk. Risks are assessed on a regular basis. And then key controls. In case there is any potential risk being identified, what are the controls associated with the matter? Has to be, they have to be recognized and documented for effective solution. For instance, the security controls are designed to safeguard any weakness in the system. In case, first, let me give you an analogy. When students are being assessed every week, small tests. So you conduct a test and assess the student. There are few students who are not preparing, or who are not understanding, or who are having problem, some other problem. That identification has to be done. After that identification is done, what are the approaches? How do you address that? If a student is not understanding a concept, remedial classes can be taken and student is given the explanation again. Secondary, that is primary thing. Secondary thing is that if a student is not showing any interest, then some counseling is done. So there is some approach to address the risk when a risk is identified. And monitoring key controls have to be monitored carefully. Why they have to monitor carefully? To find out any defect in that adopted approach for fulfilling the compliance requirements. When you are implementing an approach, whether that approach is fulfilling the compliance requirement, that has to be monitored. Reporting. Key performance indicators. There are metrics, functional metrics and KPIs defined by the organization that have to be reported on a regular basis. Like when our student attempts an exam, marks are given and then a marks report will be generated every month that includes a weekly test, how many marks a student is getting, and then assignments, exam marks, where how many students are submitting and what marks they are getting. So these things have to be documented in the form of a report. And continuous improvement. One minute. You know, after going through these steps, finally, analysis is conducted. When an analysis is conducted, whether there is any gap, any conflict, anything missing, that is identified, and then necessary corrective measures are taken to sort out the fault and improve the process. These are the steps. And why is GRC so important? The main reasons behind the importance of GRC is information explosion. There is an emergence of enormous information and information technology and advanced network communication, and all these elements have made it easier to deal with information effectively. So the more information a business can gather or store, the more chances would generate of getting competitive advantages. And therefore, everyone knows what you are doing. Your competitors knows what is your governance, what are your GRC policies. And what you have to do, you have to make them so strong. Because of this prevalence of information, you have to put out everything on your website. Your competitor get to know about that. Like scores of regulation. And there are regulatory bodies like our NAC that provides the scores. You know, there are scores A plus grade, A grade. B plus plus grade. Like this, grading also reflects the quality of the business and the standards and policies and implementation. Further, globalization of enterprises is also one of the reasons why GRC has become so important. You know, there are several companies that span across the countries and continents. And there are different regulations being followed across different geographical zones. around the world. Therefore, it is necessary to monitor and maintain country or region specific business law. Cloud computing is another reason. Cloud computing has several good effects, but it has made life difficult for enterprises, especially cloud service providers. In what way this has made the difficult, life for a cloud service provider? Because public cloud environment have been around, which allows anyone to access the cloud. It is not restricted to any particular place and any particular regulatory body, and therefore it has turned out to be quite difficult for CSPs. Okay, and these four reasons show same problem of visibility in each of them. Okay, so those four reasons make this GRC quite important. And automated GRC monitoring. What do you mean by this? Excuse me. Automated GRC monitoring is about automating the process of governance, risk management, and this compliance issues addressing. All these three things are automated. Automated in the sense there is a software. That software will take care of these monitoring, GRC monitoring tools, and there are some specialized software solutions that can automate the activities of GRC. All right. Audit and monitoring to maintain operational standard, including privacy, security, and to maintain compliance requirements. IT organization exercise two basic methods, which are system auditing and monitoring. What is system audit? System audit is a regular affair to assess the system performance, security controls, information privacy, compliance. You know, auditing, financial auditing also happens. Likewise, auditing is not only done for financial information, it's done for security controls, for privacy, for compliance, and so on. For various other operations in business, auditing can be done. And monitoring is also a regular activity that keeps track on all the activities performed on the system, such as intrusion detection and other activities. Auditing for compliance. How is auditing done for compliance? Auditing is done to check and ensure compliance requirements. And what are the steps? The steps are classify the constraint with which bar to go with the compliance standards. You know, what are the constraints? What are the contracts, customer contracts, laws, regulations, corporate policies and standards? These are different constraints. So you have to classify whether a constraint is arising due to a customer contract or law and regulation. Design and follow procedures and practices to satisfy all of such requirements. Once you classify the constraint, you should have a procedure to satisfy the requirements. Means how to address and then check periodically. You have to check periodically to see whether any violation is being done. Okay, that is internal and external audit. You know, internal auditing is performed by auditors internally in the organization, and external auditing means somebody from outside the organization. Internal audit performed by auditors within the organization, performed by external professionals. Auditors generally have much wider authorization because they are internal to the system, and they have restricted authorizations because they are coming from outside. Objective is to identify loopholes. Here the objective is to build confidence among clients and shareholders. And audit report is not published outside here. Here it is published outside the organization, and it can be done at any time. It is done once in a year. Audit framework. Auditing helps in building trust among the service provider and clients. If organizations can provide the performance and compliance audit reports to its stakeholders on a regular basis, then it develops confidence. If every year a business organization releases their audit reports, which has been performed by some professionals external to the organization, this builds confidence and then attracts more customers and clients. And the audit frameworks used by the auditor of IT services include SysTrust and WebTrust. These two are audit frameworks developed by American Institute of Certified Public Accountants and Canadian Institute of Chartered Accountants. And another one is ISO 27001. It is a standard to provide security to information security management system. And it was published by ISO. And International Electrotechnical Commission. And this framework defines how to address information security and manage risk assessment. Auditing the cloud for compliance. Cloud customers need assurance and testimony that a provider is strictly maintaining all complicated and conflicting compliance issues, right? Otherwise, no client will take the services of the provider. And in outsourced computing services, the right to audit clause is often used in the service level contract to ensure client can conduct auditing activities on their own. You know, this law facilitate clients to conduct their own auditing. In cloud services, also RTAE can be applied. RTAE is right to audit. customer, when they are storing their data and information on the cloud, they have the right to do auditing. Performing an audit on cloud is quite complex, and CSPs can adopt compliance programs based on this standard audit frameworks. All right, with this we have done with this chapter. Tomorrow we will look at another chapter, and please do that questions, objective questions tomorrow. We'll see. Any doubts in today's class? Okay, then bye.